to my very last presentation here at Dr. Libby Medical High School. Thank you all for coming to my senior defense, also known as my growth, both as a person and a student. Now my theme here is star and constellation theme, because ever since I was little, I've always had a love for space. So without further ado, here's how I reached for the stars and acquired more than I expected. Now first, I'd like to introduce you to the Manawa constellation, also known as my family. Now, I'm extremely proud to say that I'm part of this family simply because they're a group of hardworking individuals, and they try so hard to give me a good life, and they always motivate me to do great things and push me even further to higher heights. Now, over here I have my overweight dogs, and I also include Angel in this because everyone knows that me and Angel are practically sisters. And I would say that my biggest influencers are my parents, simply because throughout high school I've actually grown so much more close with them, which is more than I ever could have asked for. Now moving on to the squad constellation. Now these are a group of people that I hold very dear to my heart, simply because over my high school career they have helped me grow tremendously as a person and a student, simply because they have helped me with countless projects, assignments, and personal problems as well. And I know that I haven't included everyone on this slide, but each and every one of my friends knows that I love them with all my heart, and I know that they will do great things in life. Now on to my extracurricular. So everyone at Dojo knows when it comes to me as a person, I'm extra, so it would only be fitting for me to have a few extracurricular activities. So over here I have my church, known as the Church of Christ, also known as the Iglesia Ni Cristo in Tagalog. And this has actually given me the opportunity to not only give back to my community spiritually, but also physically as well. Numerous community hour services have been from my church, because we have done community outreach programs such as INC Giving, where we give back to the community by giving free health checkups, such as blood sugar screenings, blood pressure, etc. And we also have Reconnect up there, which is where we spread our faith throughout nearby neighborhoods. And over on the right, I have my job, Kumon, where I tutor kids and I teach them basic math and reading skills. Now, I believe that my work has made me into a more compassionate and caring person, simply because working with kids isn't easy at all. And I know that because of how patient I am with other kids, I can use these lifelong skills in my future career, which I will mention in a few moments. So here's a quote that says, "Abutin ang buwan kahit na makalitaan mo, mapupunta ka sa gitna ng magaling." Now this is a quote in Tagalog, and it is a quote by Les Brown that says, "Shoot for the moon, even if you miss, you'll land among the stars." Now this perfectly entails how my journey throughout high school, to where I've had to push myself in order to choose the right career path for me, as well as the college choice for me. So initially, freshman year, I shot for the moon, and I decided to become a neurosurgeon at Stanford University and UC Davis, until I saw the acceptance rate and the tuition. And I thought, maybe a UC just isn't the one for me, especially since my sophomore year, I actually decided on my career, where I had a lengthy talk with my mother, who is an RN, and she actually inspired and motivated me to become a registered nurse. So I narrowed it down to 4 CSUs, which are at the bottom with the exception of UNR. And I believe that I truly picked the college that I could fit in, simply because it's so diverse, and I just love the atmosphere there when I visited, and I'm proud to say that I decided to commit to San Francisco State University, and I will be entering the fall semester as a prime aider. Now, this is where I've applied as a pre-nursing student, and I hope to become a registered nurse by the end of my 4 years, and possibly a physician assistant, but that's still in the works. And I believe that SF State truly has the right atmosphere for me to grow and develop into the person that I'm meant to be. And I can also use everything that I've learned from Dojo Libby, such as my endless projects and assignments, and when I become a student here. Going on to my thesis, floating through a vast open area, I had yet to discover my destination, minor speck amongst hundreds of stars, longing to find its purpose in life. Until one day, when I found my true calling and began to shine ever so bright, radiating what I unleashed within myself. With proper guidance and help from those around me, I developed and grew beyond my own expectations. Because of my 4 years spent at Dojo Libby Medical High School, I learned how to utilize new forms of technology to effectively solve problems and seek information, apply my knowledge to real-world situations, and advocate for health-related issues. Mamahalo kita sa liwanag ng pagkakito ay nagpakita sa aking ang daan. Gayon pa man ako ay matiis ang kadiliman sa pagkakito ay nagpakita sa aking ang mga bituin. I will love the light, for it shows me the way. I will love the darkness, for it shows me the stars. Now, going into Dozier, I knew nothing would be easy for me and that I would have to adapt to new changes, especially when it came to new forms of technology, since in middle school, the only thing I knew how to use was Microsoft Word. So a perfect example of this would be the International Economic Summit. So this could also be called IES, and this is where we learn the basics of macroeconomics through a real-life simulation that narrowed it down to just our school population. So we also had to learn about how imports and exports had a global impact. So the objective of this assignment was to improve the living standard for the country that we were given, and in my case, it was the Philippines. And we also had to learn about all the influences that correlated to our country, which can be seen in the top right corner right there. And our health equity issue that we needed to improve was diabetes. Now, we had to entail this using a visual format such as a PictoChart. Now, a PictoChart was completely new to me until we had a project in Spanish 3, which is right next to it, a few weeks before I actually had to make the one for our country. Now, the PictoChart in Spanish 3 helped me to get a bit more familiar with the software, and when it came to the one that I made for all the influences for our country, it was actually a bit easier for me and my teammate to conduct. Now, math also tied into this project, such as calculating the GDP, as well, also known as the gross domestic product, by using the equation of private consumption plus gross investment plus government spending plus the difference between exports and imports. Now, we also had to use statistics within this assignment because we were given a matrix where we had our country's resources and we needed to figure out what we needed and from which country. So this is a perfect example of what we learn in economics known as scarcity, which is where there are unlimited human wants, but there are such limited resources to where all those wants could not be fully met. We had to accommodate with different countries as well as making new alliances with them to make sure that our goals could be met on the day of the summit. Now, prior to the summit, actually 2 days before the actual summit, one team from our alliance dropped out, leaving us to panic even more on the day of the summit. And on that day, we kind of just had to scramble around and look for any other outlying countries that we could align with. And this day was extremely hectic because I was the group leader and I had to take upon that role, but I nearly passed out because of how overwhelming everything was. But this has actually taught me how to come up with another plan, because even though you may think that everything is set in stone and everything may work out, it's always good to have a backup plan just in case something goes wrong. Now, another project that I needed to adapt and respond to change for in terms of technology was my medical abuses project. Now, this is a project that we did earlier in our senior year for our medical ethics class, and we had to research and teach the class about an unethical human experiment done within our history. So we had Project 4.1, which is where the American government took Marshallese people and they located them to a different island, and they bombed their homeland with over 60 nuclear bombs until they relocated all the Marshallese people back onto their homeland just to see the effects that nuclear bombs had on the human body. Now, through this, we had to create a visual representation of our whole project, and we had the option of either choosing a PowerPoint or a Prezi. Now, usually, I would opt for a PowerPoint simply because throughout high school, I've always used PowerPoints in numerous projects, and it was my comfort zone basically. But I decided maybe it's time to step it up a little bit and maybe try something new. So in this case, I use a Prezi, which you can see up there, and then these are two of my slides. So within the Prezi, I feel like it looked a lot cleaner than a PowerPoint and more visually appealing. And even though it was a bit complex and like complicated to learn at first, I sort of adapted quickly to make sure that my group had an adequate visual representation of our project. Now, tying this back into my field of study, which is nursing, the medical field always has new technology, and meaning that I need to be able to learn how to quickly adapt to those, especially once I pursue my future career. Okay, so kami ay isang bansa na komunidad, isang makinang na pagkakaiba-iba, kumalatawa tulad ng mag-a-between, tulad ng isang ibang magapun. We are a nation of communities, a brilliant diversity spread like stars, like a thousand bright points of light in a broad and peaceful sky. Now this quote, said by George H.W. Bush, perfectly entails my journey through Dozier, as well as the projects that I have conducted that have taught me a lot about how people are different and how different they can be, ranging from different races, sexual orientations, religion, and so on, as well as different disabilities. Now, this also helped me apply my knowledge to real-world situations. And a perfect example of this would be the CAM project that we conducted our sophomore year, which stands for Complementary and Alternative Medicine. Now, in this project, we had to become culturally competent by becoming aware of a country's culture and seeing how, seeing which condition or disease profusely affects the citizens. So in our case, we have the country of Samoa, and we had to split our group into different roles, which include the traditional healer, the allopathic physician, the immigrant health specialist, and the patient. Now, my patient was a 27-year-old female who had stage 3A breast cancer, and we had to find out different ways on how to tackle that problem. So for the allopathic physician, which was my role, I gave her advice that entailed more to Western medicine, such as prescribing her drugs or a biopsy to make sure that all of her lymph nodes stay intact and cancer-free. I also suggested chemotherapy and radiation therapy. However, for the traditional healer, they focused on a more holistic approach, meaning that they focused more on the mind and the body and spirit rather than just that area that was affected. So with this, the traditional healer suggested that the patient undergo massages, and they also ingest herbs and strengthen their faith through prayer, since Christianity was very big, or is very big in Samoa. Now this project taught me how to respect other cultures by not basing my actions on what stereotypes the world may have for that specific race, but rather what the patient actually tells me and what they believe and what they were raised to believe. Moving on to my sci-fi research essay, this is also a project where I had to apply what I learned to real-world situations. So this is an essay that we did our junior year that included our English class and our physiology class. So here we had to defend or refute the legitimacy of the human biological and physiological concepts that were made throughout a science fiction movie. So in my case, my movie was The Hunger Games, and I defended the fact that a person can undergo hallucinations and they can also withstand certain explosions to an extent, which is what one of the main characters, Katniss Everdeen, had to go through. But then I also argued against the fact that if someone has a large gash or wound on their body and their blood becomes infected, they can't simply treat that with a topical ointment, which is what happened to Peter Millard in the movie. So here I had to gather my resources independently, and I had to challenge the events that happened within this movie with concrete evidence rather than just saying, oh, I think that maybe this happened, maybe this should happen, or et cetera. So here we had to write a 1,500-word essay, which was a bit of a struggle for me since I'd never written an essay that also had to make sure to make it into MLA format for my English class and APA format for my science class. And surprisingly, I did well on it, but I know that there's still room for improvement. Now, this helped me learn to advocate for patients using concrete evidence instead of just prescribing them like what I believe or what I think should happen to them. Moving on to another project, we had Project Eddie our senior year, and Eddie stands for Envision, Design, Discover, Invent, and Execute. Now, this project helped to break down the mental barriers that stood in between disabled people and able people by creating a device that would help the disabled person rather than just trying to fix them. So our patient was one of our group members, which is Taylor De Ocampo, and she had scoliosis, and she prescribed her problems to us as having difficulty lifting heavy objects and cleaning hard to reach areas in her household. So we decided to focus on the more cleaning aspect of it, and we created Dwayne the Rod Johnson, because you can clean the Dwayne and you can clean the Johnson. So over here, this was our prototype where we focused more on like the lifting aspect of carrying heavier objects. But the problem with this was that it was pretty ironic because the rod was a bit heavy. And then over there, we have our final product where we attached a foam carrier to the end of the rod, and we could insert a whiteboard eraser or a sponge or a duster into it to help her clean hard to reach areas. Now, this applied to physics because it used a second class lever. An example would be up here, such as a wheelbarrow, where the fulcrum was the user's hand, the effort was being placed on the rest of the rod, and the weight was at the end where the detachable head was. This also applied to Newton's first law, which states that any object at rest stays at rest, and any object in motion stays at motion unless acted upon. Now, you can see here that if we just leave the rod on a table or the floor, it won't move unless we put manual force on it and actually pick it up and use it. This also applied to physics by using friction. Now, when you take it and you clean a surface, the force that you are exerting has opposite force, which is the friction, and it also includes the weight and the gravitational force and normal force being put onto it as well. Now, this project here helped me to learn how to be more sensitive towards those who are disabled, while at the same time not pitying them, because there is a difference there. And I feel that since we were helping them and not fixing them, it really changed me as a person, and it changed my perspective towards disabled people, because in our medical ethics class, we actually learned the term ableism, which is the discrimination against disabled people. And it taught me to learn how to use non-ableist terms. And some ableist terms include crippled or retarded, which are extremely offensive to those that are disabled. Okay, so I believe that this would help me in my future career as nurse in nursing, because I will be working with an extremely diverse group of people, especially if I'm in a general hospital setting, which means that I would have to be culturally competent, meaning that I would have to understand their heritage, where they come from, and what they're raised to believe in, rather than just my own practices. And I also have to realize that disabled people are people too, because a lot of people don't think that way. And with the sci-fi research essay, I learned how to advocate for patients using concrete evidence instead of what I believe was best for them. Ang paraan ang isang kaponan ay gumaganap bilang isang buong tumutukoy sa tumumbay nito. Ikaw ay maaaring makaroon ang pinakamalaking grupo ng mga individual na pagkakitlin sa mundo. Ngunit kung hindi nila ilalay ng nakasama, ang group ay hindi katumbas ng kalagandang daraya. Now, this is a quote by Babe Ruth that says, "The way a team plays as a whole determines its success. You could have the greatest bunch of individual stars in the world, but if they don't play together, they won't be worth a dime." Now, Dozier has put me into numerous settings where I had to work with a team, whether I personally knew them or not, which helped me to collaborate with others effectively, as well as using my own leadership skills to make sure that everyone was on task and everyone was doing what they needed to do. Now, this could be seen here in the Right to Die debate. Now, this is a debate that we did our sophomore year, where we had to choose an ethical issue and either defend or refute it. Now, for my issue, I had euthanasia, and I was for euthanasia, meaning that I had to defend it, because I believe that everyone has the right to die. Now, Here we had to collaborate with a partner. In this case, I had two partners, and I believe that my collaboration skills were terrible because I didn't talk to them at all, and I felt that on the day of the actual debate, I was extremely nervous and unprepared, and I felt that my group members were unprepared as well. Now, these skills can be related to, these skills obviously needed to improve, which can be seen in my Be the Change project. Now, in my Be the Change project, we did this for medical ethics our senior year, and this is where we have to raise awareness for certain issues in the world that fail to receive the amount of attention they deserve. So here we had to come up with a way to advocate for victims for domestic abuse, which is what my group chose. And so here we had to choose two actions, and one of our actions was to do the Words of Wisdom at school. So we knew that everyone was listening to the Words of Wisdom, so it could spread around easily. And we also came to school with shirts that we made that have common phrases of misconception on it, such as "it was my fault" or "don't be a wimp." And we wanted to focus more on how men can be abused too, and not just women, and how verbal abuse counts as abuse as well. Now, we also had to make a pechakucha, which is basically a PowerPoint presentation where each slide was 15 seconds long and the whole presentation was 5 minutes long. And we also did a public simulation where our group took it to the public and we went to Target and the streets of Brentwood to simulate an actual domestic abuse encounter. So one of my group members pretended to abuse me, and we wanted to film their reactions and see what they would do in reaction to that. Now, unfortunately, only one person actually stood up amongst about 10 people, and that showed to us that people think that, oh, maybe in a domestic abuse encounter I will speak up and become an upstander, but really most people are bystanders. So we wanted to break that and make sure that everyone can learn how to be an upstander in their community. Now, I feel that I have developed into a more sensitive and well-rounded person because of this project, since I got to experience it, but more on the surface. And I also had to collaborate with my group members as well through Google Docs, Google Slides, and iMessage. This has also made me into a more empathetic and aware person, simply because you never know what's going on behind the scenes of a person's life. Now onto my last artifact. My CPR certification is where I experienced hands-on patient care, which I will definitely need in the medical field. Now with this, I needed excellent communication skills and leadership skills, because in our sports medicine class where we conducted this test, we had to have two people on a team where one person was doing compressions on the chest and the other person was at the head of the mannequin giving breaths using the bag valve mask. So with this, we also need to learn how to use an AED, also known as the automated external defibrillator. And with this project, we learned how to be an upstanding citizen, just like it would be the Change Project, because if someone faints and they have no pulse and they're not breathing, then you can't just stand around and make sure someone else does the job that you're able to do. You have to make that decision in that moment to make sure that that person lives, which ties into nursing as well, because I know that as a nurse, since I will be working in a general hospital setting, I will have to work in a fast-paced environment and make decisions right there and then, and I don't have any time to contemplate, oh, should I do this, should I do that? I have to be able to know what to do. Going on to my revisited thesis, the rigorous curriculum offered here at Dojo Libby Medical High School has shaped me into a solid young woman, eager for the next chapter. My high school experience was anything but normal, yet I'm glad to say that I've made it this far in my life, and I feel that I